reason is I have a really interest in improving public education. I think it's the biggest challenge that we have is how do we make our public education better and stronger and more successful. Title of my little speech here is the Kettering School Board's biggest challenge is to gain public support for transformation. What has to drive every system is an aim or purpose. It says you can't have a system unless you really know what you're trying to accomplish. And then all of your resources, all of your policies, all of your budget, and everything that you're doing ought to be centered on accomplishing that mission. You know, if you're a church, you have a mission. You need to look at what you're doing in your policies and your budgets and your activities. Are you just running around doing things, or are you trying to accomplish something? Are you trying to accomplish the mission that you say you're trying to accomplish? So it's very important for schools to have a mission statement, but the problem is it's just sort of all devolved down into test scores, because that's the only thing anyone pays attention to.
We haven't said
the last word of what quality should be in Kettering. We should be and are capable of being much more. We're the adolescent that has great potential, but we're not going to do anything with it unless we have some discipline, unless we have a plan. It's easy to say and to make big ideas. That's the easy part. The hard part is really to come up with a plan and a process to do that. And whenever you try to make change or whenever you try to make transformation, you're going to end up offending somebody. You're going to end up threatening somebody. And so this requires real leadership, but what it really requires in schools is public support. You can't do anything unless you have the support of the public. And David Matthews of the Kettering Foundation wrote that democracy is what we need in order to have a vital school system. We can't have a vital school system unless we have a vital democracy that supports it. So that's some of my ideas for my campaign. And I will hope that you will help me contact other people that might want to support that. And I'm hoping that between now and November 5th, there'll be a lot of occasions where there'll be chances for discussion and where there'll be chances for people to come together to talk about their schools and what they might hope for the future of them to be. Thank you very much.
Support for what you want to do, you're going to have to go one step further and show why is test scores not enough. You know, what is it that...
I think what you're saying is there needs to be a reason for change.
Exactly.
And I think a lot of times it's like any commercial that you see tries to create a dissonance so that, you know, you have a gap, you feel a gap between where you are
and where you should be.
Mm-hmm. And that causes, you know, an uncomfortableness. You know, I need to get those new pair of gym shoes so that I can be cool, you know. You know, what do people want in a school system, I think, has been said a lot of times in mission statements that we've overlooked. We want our children to be independent thinkers. We want children to learn how to become leaders in their community. Mm-hmm. You know, we want children to be able to analyze things. We need to have children who are ready for civic responsibility. We say that in the United States, the citizens are sovereigns. How do you prepare a sovereign to take on responsibility that they should be taking on in terms of operating in their own government? And we're not doing a very good job with that. We're not doing a very good job in terms of really engaging students in their own learning. You know, what percentage of students in Kettering High School are really working to their potential? How many are floating and not really doing a whole lot? You know, how many are really stretching themselves and really trying as hard as they should be trying? You know, we've created a situation where it's all about getting grades, and a lot of kids can get grades without doing much about it. Now, what are we doing to come up with the intrinsic motivation to help people to do their best? But I think, you know, I think you're right and right on point is that, again, if I'm going to convince people that their schools need transformation, the logical question is why. You know,
exactly.
Our schools are wonderful. Our
exactly.
schools are great. But the, you know, if have we reached the pinnacle of success in Kettering here? Have we done what we said we wanted to do with schools? If you go back and look 20 years, 30 years ago, in terms of what the school philosophy was in Kettering, about what we really wanted students to experience as part of their education, we're falling very, very short of that because we've completely forgotten about it.
Kettering is sort of like an adolescent that has great potential.
And the challenge for Kettering is somehow to live up to that potential. You know, how good could public schools be in Kettering? And I think we have the capacity, because we are a community that has a good history to it, because we are a community that has some prosperity, we are a community that has a lot of citizens with civic, that want to have civic responsibility. Because of all those things, we have great potential. But how do we bring that together to actually accomplish anything is the next thing. And so that's where my general idea is that the challenge for a school board is really one of leadership. How do we create a situation where we have the public support that we need in order to make this big leap in quality that's possible?
Look at the camera too.
So here's what I wrote about, I was limited to 75 words. I said, public education needs transformation. To achieve 21st century quality, we must stop simply replicating the present system. Authentic change is rare because it's not easy. It requires leadership and strong public support. The biggest challenge for the Kettering School Board is to inspire and empower teachers and citizens to work together to define system excellence and to create a plan for long-term transformation. So this not everybody would agree with. Not everybody thinks that Kettering schools need transformation. A lot of people in the system are pretty satisfied with it. So for me to say, you know, elect me through the school board because I think that our system needs transformation, is sort of going out on a limb. I probably might be better if I really just want to get elected to just kind of try to slide in there by being nice and smiling and talking to people. But I want to create a discussion that I think that is worthwhile to have a discussion about. And that is, you know, what's the purpose of our schools? What are we trying to accomplish? I think a big purpose has to tie into this idea of, are we accomplishing what we might call the common good in education in our schools? You know, why are we paying our tax money? And what's the purpose for this? It has to be something more than just test scores. We need to be preparing children to be active and successful citizens. We need preparing children to be ready to work in a democracy and serve in democracy and participate in a democracy. Our children are our future, and it has a lot to do more than just with learning something about technology or coming up with better math and science. The challenge for a school board is really one of leadership. How do we create a situation where we have the public support that we need in order to make this big leap in quality that's possible? But I want to create a discussion that I think
is worthwhile
to have.